Welcome to our ThruText How to Launch a Campaign tutorial. In this video, I'll show you how to create and launch a new campaign using ThruText. To start, click on Create a New Campaign on the ThruText dashboard. In ThruText, there are six basic steps to create a campaign and launch it. In the first step, we will set the basic parameters of the campaign. First, you'll need to create a name for the campaign. Here's a tip. Make sure you're using a good naming convention so that it's easy for you and your team to tell what your campaign is about. Let's name our campaign Bartlett Test 2021 Rally Interest. The description you enter here will be one of the first things your senders see in the messenger, so you should share notes and instructions with them here. It's a good way to tell your texters who to contact when they have questions as well. We're going to let our senders know we want them to be sure to answer all the survey questions where applicable. We are going to be texting contacts on the East Coast, so we'll leave the country set to the United States and then set the time zone as US Eastern. Next, in the Use Case section, you can select the use case appropriate for your campaign. Please review the guides linked within this Use Case selection section if you have any questions on that part of the process. The start date and time will dictate when the campaign opens, so let's set our start time to October 23rd, 21 at 9 a.m. If we launched our campaign before that time, our senders would get notified the campaign is live, but would not have any visible conversations when they go to their assignment. If we want them to get started texting immediately, then we will need to set the start time prior to the current time. So we'll set it a day prior to October 22nd at 1 p.m. The end time is when the campaign will close for initial messages to be sent. However, replies can still be received and responded to after that time if necessary. Both the start and end times can be edited after the campaign is launched, so if you need to give your senders more time to complete their initial assignments, that's easy to do. Since this is for a rally tomorrow, I'm setting our end time for tomorrow at 9 p.m. The daily open and close times are when your senders can start sending texts each day and when all texting will stop for the evening. Let's leave our open and close time set to 9 a.m. Eastern and 9 p.m. Eastern, respectively. Now, we want to text people in Boston, Massachusetts, so let's select the 617 area code as our first region and the 857 area code as our second region. Depending on the availability of numbers in those two areas, we might not have enough numbers to launch our campaign. For that reason, let's select Massachusetts All as my third region. Using a region like Massachusetts All, in this case, as the second or third option, is recommended so that the system has a larger pool of area codes to launch with. These regions can pull from any area code within the state, or part of the state, so if you don't have a specific area code you want to use, you can select a larger region as your first region. You can even choose two or three different regions to broaden your number availability. Next, you will target your campaign. You can either add a group or target groups from a previous campaign. The groups option will produce a list of all the groups you have uploaded into ThruText that have not been archived. The past campaigns option will show you every campaign your organization has run, including archived campaigns. With the past campaign option, you can also target based on several options, such as what responses you received on one or more survey questions, or the reply status from a previous campaign. I'm going to select the group that we created in our previous tutorial, New Group, October 21, 2021, and then select Set Base Segment. Remember that if you don't press Set Base Segment, ThruText will not let you proceed. Once you have selected your first base segment, which is the group of people you want to text, you can add additional segments the same way. To get even more detailed, you can choose to add to the existing segments or remove from them as well. We call this advanced targeting, but I'm not going to go into too much detail on that for this tutorial. For a more in-depth look at targeting, please review our How to Target Your Campaign tutorial and check out our Help Center article on campaign targeting. Step 2 is where you'll add senders to your campaign. In the Choose Manually column, we see a list of all the senders in my organization. I can click the plus by their name to add them to the Chosen Sender column. In this case, I'm going to make Heather the sender. When you add senders this way, ThruText is going to evenly distribute an equal number of conversations to all your senders when you launch your campaign. For example, if you have 1,000 contacts and 4 senders, each would get 250 conversations assigned to them. You can also skip choosing senders in campaign creation and add them after launch. On to step 3. As you can see, we have a number of fields available to use when crafting our initial message. These are partly the required fields, first name and last name, as well as any custom fields that we included in our group upload. In this case, city. You can also use the sender's first or last name to further personalize your message. I'm going to make my initial message say, "Hi, first name. This is sender first name with Test 2021. We are having a big rally in city on Saturday. Can you make it?" You can see in the preview box below that it shows exactly what this message will look like and even shows actual contact data from the group we uploaded, which helps you double check that you've mapped your information correctly. If we start going too long, we might receive a message warning us that some carriers might break the message up into multiple segments. The character count warning is not going to be exact, since the dynamic data in our custom fields can vary in length. Just try to keep your initial message short and engaging to get a better response rate. You can also check out our help desk guide, Text Message Segments, for additional information on this. Now, let's click Next and move on to step 4. This step involves creating recommended replies, which are the replies that all of your senders will use to answer some of the expected questions they'll get in their conversations. Note that some of the same custom fields that were in the initial messages are in the recommended replies as well. They can be used to add dynamic data to your recommended replies in the same way. For example, we know that there will be people that say yes, so we should create a reply called "Will attend" with "Great, the rally is at 123 Main Street at 2 p.m. See you there." Some might say, "I can't come to this event, but I'm interested in future events." So we want to create a reply called "Can't come, but interested" that says, "No worries, we'll make sure you're on the list for next time." You can make as many recommended replies as you think are necessary to answer common questions. Just don't go overboard. You want to focus on common replies to typical questions, not infrequent cases. You can also add more reply options after launching if needed. Let's click Next and move on to step 5, creating survey questions. There are 4 types of survey questions: yes, no for yes, no binary questions, multiple choice questions for more than a yes, no, but only one answer is selectable, checkbox or multiple choice questions with more than one answer selectable, and freeform, a question where the senders type in a freeform response for our campaign. I'm going to create a question that asks if they are attending the rally as a multiple choice question. So our answers are going to be yes, no, and maybe. Notice that I put a comma between each answer. That's how ThruText knows they are individual answers. Since you want to know if people want to come to future events, that's going to be our second question. Do you want to attend future events? We can set that as a yes or no question. Our last question is, can we get your email address? That's so we can send out a reminder about the event, as well as any other upcoming events. This question is going to be a freeform question. You want to gather as much information as needed with your survey questions, but try not to have too many questions that could confuse your senders. When we click Next, we'll move on to the last step, which is the review. This is your chance to proof everything you set up in the previous steps. We can double check our start time, open time and close times, area codes, and targeting. If you're unsure of something, you can click on the step you want to verify and come back. Once you're certain everything looks good, scroll to the bottom and click Launch. You'll see a dialog that says Launching, which will also notify your senders via email that they have an assignment on an active campaign. You can see the campaign go from draft to active status. That means the email notifications have gone out and the conversations are queued up for the senders. That is how you launch a campaign in ThruText. If you have any questions, please check out our Help Center or reach out to us at support@getthrough.io. Happy texting!